All right, every once in a while, a steak and potato meal is in order. For me, it's all the time. And today we are showing you a delicious recipe with the help of Tom Harvey. He is the executive chef for Eddie V's Prime Seafood and a new resident to Arizona.
Yes.
Welcome to Sonoran Living and Arizona.
Thank you, Andy. Thank you.
So you guys opened Eddie V's on Valentine's Day. You reopened it. You had another location and you've
right.
moved it. And how are things going?
Beautiful new location at Scottsdale Quarter. As you said, we opened Valentine's Day and everyone has really come out and shown us a lot of support. It's been really busy every night. Our bar is terrific late night, so we stay open late. Lots of great food later on in the evening. So
looks like lots of wine too.
Yeah, we have it. We have it. Absolutely.
Well, I think wine is perfect. A nice red, right, with some steak and potatoes.
Absolutely.
Would you agree?
Yeah.
See, I'm learning. Okay, so what are we making today?
Well, the steak we're going to do today are hanger steaks, and you know, if I'm having a really nice steak, a fancy one, an expensive one, like a filet or a ribeye, I'm going to go somewhere like Eddie V's and let us cook it. But hanger steaks are one of my favorites to do at home. They're very inexpensive. They've become readily available at really in almost any high-end grocery store now. And basically, they take a marinade really well. So what we're going to do with these is just do a really simple little marinade here.
And what would that marinade consist of?
This is a little bit of soy sauce and sesame oil we're going to pour on first, okay?
Andy, do you know what the hanger steak, where it comes from? Like, what? I've never heard of that before.
Well, hanger steak
I didn't want to say that because I thought I'd be the only one. So I'm glad you said that,
well,
Stephanie.
Well, and I thought you knew because you know so much about steak and potatoes.
Yeah,
well,
that's me.
It's actually commonly known as a hanging tender, and there's actually only one hanger steak per cow, and it's actually the very back of the tenderloin muscle.
So this is four cows right here.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. So it has a really nice texture, and as I said, what I really like about it, it picks up flavors from marinades. So we're just put some garlic and shallots and ginger, put a little bit of spicy serrano chilies on here. We'll put this in the fridge to marinate. Really,
and turn it a couple times.
Exactly. Really, any amount of time it goes up until two nights, it's just going to keep getting better with more and more marination.
Two nights, you said?
Yeah, nights in the fridge will be great, covered.
Well, looking at this one, you could definitely see how it changed color.
Yeah, this is one that we actually put in about 36 hours ago with the same marinade, so you can see it's really done a great job of picking up all these flavors. And we're basically just going to take these out of here.
I mean, obviously, you can put it with a flank steak or any kind of
steak. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Steak,
the marinade, and I believe y'all are going to put the recipe on the website, it's a fantastic for really any cut of steak you want to do. So it really is nice.
It'll get warm in a minute.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Trust us.
You're new here.
We are, insert the sizzle right now. One,
ready?
Two, three.
But these are great. They'll cook really nice in a pan. They're also fantastic for the to go on the grill. So
promise that's going to get warm.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So while that is doing that, you're going to cook it on both sides, obviously.
Yeah,
all
just
sides.
Just see some nice color. Yeah.
Okay. And that's it for the steak?
Yeah, absolutely. And what we'll do is cook these to about internal temperature about 130 degrees. I like these medium rare to medium. We'll let them have a good long rest so they stay juicy when we slice them. And I've actually got some over
here.
Wait,
real quick, what do you mean by good long rest? So when you take it off of the stove, you just let it sit there, you don't cut into it right away?
Well, one of the keys to really having steak nice, when it's cooking, all the juices rush to the center.
Mm-hmm.
And I think one of the most common mistakes people make when they do meat at home is not letting it rest long enough. And the restaurant business is automatic to us. You let the meat rest for a while, and all the juices get back evenly distributed. That's why when you have a steak at a nice place like Eddie V's, when you cut into it, it'll be the same color from edge to edge. And we've got some here, and these have actually been seared off and cooked to medium rare, and we'll slice these a little bit later on.
Perfect. We are actually going to let you do what you need to do with this, and we are going to come back in just a little bit.
Great.
We're going to make some twice-baked potatoes, which, you know, our mouths are just salivating over.
We're just getting started.